and fighting out of the red corner this evening. He's wearing the purple trunks trimmed in red and white and weighed in at a fit and ready 145.5 pounds. His professional record, an excellent one. 5 victories, no defeats, 1 draw, with 3 big wins coming by way of knockout. From the great fighting borough of Brooklyn, USA, ladies and gentlemen, here's Mikkel Slick Mick Lespierre.
We're checking it here post-fight. 5-star Banquet Hall, Long Island City, Queens, New York, left of the screen. None other than Slick Mick, Slickington Mickington, Mikkel Lespierre, now 6-0, Mikkel Lespierre. To the right of the screen, of course, we got Don Saxby, as always, classing up the joint. But first and foremost, I'm going to swing it over to you, Don. Why don't you go ahead and break down Mick's performance tonight?
Well, you know what? Like everybody was telling me, he looked sharp, and for me, he actually did look pretty sharp, but I can actually see the ring rust as well. But for the most part, you know, I'm actually pleased. You know, had it been a 6th rounder, we'd have probably gotten him out of there because he actually admitted that the body shots were killing him. But, you know, overall, he hasn't fought in a long time, so I'm actually, like, I'm content, and I'm actually pretty pleased with that performance. You know, could he did a little more? Yeah, why do more than you have to when the fight is at, you know, pretty, well, you know, being kind of easy for us. So, like I said, I like what I saw. He was using his jab. He was listening. Straight away, he did straight away from the body plan, from the game plan that we performed, because we knew how the guy pretty much fought. But like I said, for the most part, I'm really, really content. And he'll only get better. Like I said, we didn't, just like Killer Cam, they fought a week apart almost a year ago. So this was like a big plus. I wish it was 6 rounds, but you know, I'll take it. I'll take the win. This fight is over. I'm happy with it. I like his performance. I like his body work. I like the slickness. And that was good. You know what I mean? So, like I said, we can just go on. To the next one, that's it.
And at the end of the day, all that matters is that 5 turned to a 6.
That's it.
And that 0 stayed a 0.
Absolutely.
But Mick, I'm going to swing it over to your side now. Break down your own performance for you. How'd you feel after 9 months out of the ring?
I really felt rusty, but that's no excuse. I still went in there and did what I had to do. I took my time, you know, stayed relaxed. The guy was pretty, you know, awkward, long, you know, and then you have to understand so I'm fighting above my weight class just to get these fights. So, you know, I just took my time and paced myself and what I had to do.
Absolutely. And you know, you're a tough, gritty dude in there, Mick. Obviously, there's no tape out there. You didn't know exactly how to prepare for who you were fighting. Kind of went there, did your thing. But the body shots were definitely damaging. You know, how'd you feel, you know, just kind of cumulatively and overall, you know, just how'd you feel, you know, after the 4 rounds are over, you know, to know that the rust is shook off, you know, and you got that action again?
I just feel like I'm ready to get back at it next month. You know, I just wanted to stay active. Not being the show. It takes a toll on you when you're not as active and you're on the show. You lose your timing of everything, your grit, your aggressiveness. You know, that can stay in the gym. But a fight is totally different. When the headgear is off and the gloves is, you know what I'm saying, the gloves are smaller and you're a different feel. Lights are on you, pressure is on you, so it's definitely different. I want to, you know, get accustomed to fighting on a consistent basis. That way, if I do have a guy like him in front of me, I had him with the body shots, and I could have dug, you know what I'm saying, dug for that extra just to get him out of there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm granted, if it was a 6-rounder, I'm more than likely sure he would have win. Because as the rounds went on, I started touching him more. You know, I got more comfortable with my space and my distance. But, you know, if I was out of a 1 to 10, I'd give myself a 5. You know.
And you as a trainer, Don, when you hear, you know, Mick break down a performance like that, you know, it was a dominant, unanimous decision win. He scored a knockdown, and on a scale of 1 to 10, he gives himself a 5. And what that obviously tells you is you have a fight on your hands, which you already know. I'm already telling you something you already know that aspires for greatness. You know, how special is it to work with a guy like Cam, or Cam and Mick, who both, you know, they aspire for that greatness, and they rate their performances low when they go out there and, you know, do dominant things?
Let me tell you why I love working with him. Because I trust him. I always tell people I trust my fighters. A lot of times you hear the fighters say, yo, I trust my trainer. But as a trainer, I trust my fighters. I trust that they're going to do out there and follow the game plan that we worked on. You know, sometimes we get a different opponent, a drop of a notice. You know what I mean? We originally prepared for a southpaw. And, you know, I think two or three days before the fight, we wound up getting a righty. But that's, you know, it doesn't matter. You know, we got the best of both worlds. Like, we were boxing the Barrera brothers. One's a righty and one's a lefty.
Right.
So we were, like, well prepared for whatever came. I mean, plus, remember, he's got 60 or 70 some amateur fights. He's boxed with some of the best people. It doesn't matter. So, you know, we prepared for whoever. I appreciate the fact that he acknowledged the fact he gave himself a 5. I gave him a 7. I was fine with that. I really was. I would have gave him a 9 or 8 if we had a 6 round. You know, but like I said, you know, you've seen the rerush. You've seen the rerush because at certain points in the fight, he didn't pull the trigger. You know, but what I did like is some of the like dirty stuff that we worked on, we were using. You see, the guy gets up under you and he does, and you can't get a shot off, you lean on him. Make him use his back to try to get himself back up. And what I did actually like was that nice, pretty checkup that he got. That was a long-time, it was a well-placed punch. It was good. You know, I could tell that the guy, he was ready to go. He was ready to go. Like, after the third round, he was ready to go. But he's just throwing desperation punches. And I was fine. You know, he was just trying to land whatever he could land. It is what it is. Like, we'll take it. We'll take it on to the next one. You know, after he wins the next one, his fighters are actually forgotten about.
Right.
I mean, after he wins the next one, that fight is actually forgotten about. We just keep on progressing until we get to the point where we need to get to a world title shot. And that's the ultimate goal. If that's not the ultimate goal, it's the sense of fighting.
No doubt about it. Now, Mick, I'm going to throw it over to you one last time. You got any closing comments for the people out there?
I just want to thank everybody for showing me support, especially yes. Resolution Sports.
Yes.
That's been there from day one. You know, I just, you know, I appreciate everybody that came out.
Those Slick Mick shirts were out there banging tonight.
That's what I'm saying. Everybody had a shirt, you know, supporting the
side,
like they always do, you know, and it's greatly appreciated. I do it for them, you know, more so than anything, you know. They want to see my dream come to life. So, you know, it's a good feeling when you have supporters like that, you know, to come out there and just root you on. You know, you want to put on a good show. You don't want to look bad, you know. Give it your all, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I just want to thank everybody for that, and definitely Resolution Sports. You know, you guys always be
Rest there. Sports for life.
That's it.
Also, I want to thank you. Come on in here, man. I don't like you, but nah, it's my man. I want to thank his manager, George Javaris. You know, he was a big instrumental part of us getting on this card, you know, and that's what we needed. We work hand in hand to get him to the point where we need to get him, and we're going to get there. We're going to get there. You know what I mean? Like I said, you know, Rest Sports for life. John Archibald, man, we love you, bro.
You already.
Appreciate it, man.
Rest Sport Polo, but y'all to see the shirt I got underneath, you know what I mean?
He's got his big shirt on.
But we'll go ahead and slam the door in this interview here now, but I want to thank all three of you gentlemen for the constant hospitality. Always looking out for me on my side. It's definitely a two-way street. You know, I wouldn't keep coming back here if I didn't have full faith and belief in what you and the whole team, and even that dude Cam, even though he split on us, even what he's doing.
Get on.
But, yeah, get on out. But just one last time, Team Mikkel Lespierre, we're going to close it out. Thank y'all for sharing some time.
Best sports for life. We out.
Saga continues.
Saga continues. That's what I'm talking about.
Ladies and gentlemen, after four exciting rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge at ringside, Tom Carosone scored the bout 40-35. Judge Alan Nace saw it at 39-36. And Judge John Stewart scored it 40-35. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And still undefeated, Mikkel Slick Mick Lespierre.